Hello and welcome. Thanks for joining us. We bring you Friday baseball on the show. It's the Chicago White Sox taking on the Houston Astros. First pitch coming at you right after the break. Just about set to go. And our pitcher in this game, Roy Oswalt.
Been a very solid pitcher throughout his career. ERA around 3.5. What I like is he competes, he stays in the game, and he gives his team an opportunity to win.
Here's Tim Anderson.
Leading off the night for the White Sox, the shortstop, Tim Anderson.
The 1-1. Good eye in that spot. This ball's chopped on the ground. Yeah, they take care of Anderson for the out. Time to check out the lineup for the White Sox. It features a great veteran presence, Frank Thomas.
Well, this is a player that's, you know, hit over 300 for his career in terms of batting average. And being able to do that, that is extremely good bat-to-ball skills that he's had for a long time. He's just got a real consistent approach, uses all fields, and he's got a game plan when he comes to the plate. So let's just keep our eyes on him. I think it's pretty hard to take.
Swing, and this one's blasted. It's got a chance. Feeling for the wall as he makes the catch.
Man, I love that route. The ball was smoked. He knew he had to get back to the track right away. Turned his back on the infield. Got to the spot, turned around, and made a nice catch.
Here's a 1-1. And a foul ball. Next pitch is outside. Got him. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Nothing doing for the White Sox. Now here come the Astros. No score. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Back here at Minute Maid Park. And today's starting pitcher, Lucas Giolito. What do we need to know here?
Yeah, ERA last year was a little worse than average, so I'll definitely be looking for better results this season. You know, one of the keys is just being able to have a consistent delivery and to be able to repeat that delivery so you can hit the spots that you want to hit and have a higher chance of being successful.
Kicks and fires.
Down to 3-2.
Swing and a miss, struck him out.
And he'll be beating himself up on the way back to the dugout. Got a pitch to hit and just couldn't get to it. I think that slider really caught way more of the plate than it was supposed to.
Here's Michael Brantley. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. Some high cheese for strike three.
Been a pretty rough start to this series for him at the plate. Three strikeouts in the first game yesterday. Another one right there. They've clearly got a great plan for how to deal with this guy right now.
That hits the dirt, and it's 2-1. You know, we talk so much about how guys prepare for a start. For Giolito, one of the things that's really cool, he actually uses scouting reports and then plays MLB The Show to execute how he's going to go about attacking hitters. Close, but called a ball, and that's ball three. So the night before his start, he effectively goes over the lineup he anticipates he's going to face and plays the game. So he goes through an entire opposing lineup on MLB The Show. Oh, this is deep to left center. Way back there. On its way. Gone. That one felt good. His first homer of the year. And it gives him the lead in the first. It's 1-0. He absolutely crushed that one.
No doubt about that one, Boog. We knew it wasn't coming back.
Hey.
knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
And here now is the Astros cleanup hitter, Craig Biggio. He was hitless in four at-bats yesterday. Next offering is in for a strike. For Giolito, it actually is an idea that kind of came together with his buddy Max Fried. They played together in high school in Los Angeles, and they're not sure who started it first, but in 2019, they each began to go over scouting reports using MLB The Show. In the dirt, over to first, gets him easily, ends the inning. Astros notch a run on the solo homer. It's now 1-0. Top of the second. Here's the cleanup hitter for the Sox, Paul Konerko. The wide to kick the pitch. Swing and a miss. And that is strike two. Off the outside edge, and now the count is 2-2. Eric Summersgill, our plate umpire.
One thing to watch out for, Boog, is what side of the plate Summersgill might be favoring. He usually sets up at an angle. Pitchers sometimes will try to figure that out early so they can attack that spot and get as many strike calls as possible. Frustrating end to the at-bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
That misses, and that's ball three. And there's a strike.
3-1 count. Saying to himself, I've got to get a fastball here. Just spins a get-me-over breaking ball to bring the count full.
Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. One down, base is empty. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
Pretty good pitch on 3-2, right around the knees, but just no help from the umpire.
Luis Robert now. The 1-2. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Righty to the plate. Got him. Too long. Yoan Moncada with a chance to hit. The 1-1. That one hammered left field. That's back. And that one is going to go. A shot to the opposite field, and the White Sox jump out in front. It's 2-1.
A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
Two outs, nobody on. Sebi Zavala steps to the plate for the White Sox. So now 1-2. The pitch. That's off the mark. Two balls, two strikes. On the ground, right side. And it hits the bag. The flip to the pitcher covering. And that is that.
First, it looks like making the stop is the hardest part. But feeding to the pitcher on the move, I think even tougher. Great job of hitting that moving target. They're going to be fired up in the dugout.
bottom of the second. Here's Kyle Tucker. Singing, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He's the ultimate professional, and it doesn't just start at game time. It starts in the afternoon, the way he prepares and gets ready for the ball game. I tell you what, his teammates feed off of the leadership that he shows on and off the field.
Next pitch downstairs, and the count is 2-2.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
And there's one down.
Batting six. No left fielder.
Now it's Yordan Alvarez. Alvarez is from Cuba. He grew up idolizing a future teammate, Yuli Gurriel, who is 13 years his senior. Next pitch misses, and it's 2-1.
Now, Boog, you remember back in 2020, Lucas Giolito threw that no-hitter against the Pirates. He struck out 13, and the only base runner he allowed was on a walk in the fourth inning. I tell you what, if I was on the Pirates, he'd have had a perfect game.
Three-one, and he couldn't come up with it.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Runner on at first with one gone. And now it's Alex Bregman. Three-one now. Fouled off. He was late. Three-two now. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Oh, nothing too fancy on the strikeout pitch right there. Just a low 90s fastball. I'm not sure he was trying to challenge him, but that's pretty much what happened. Very hittable location, but he found a way to just get it by him.
Now at the plate, Jeremy Pena. Homered in the ball game yesterday afternoon. And a pitch. In the air, left side. Mendoza drifts towards it. And makes the play, and that's out number three. One left for Houston. They're down 2-1. Back here in Houston, here's Elvis Andrus.
The second baseman, Elvis Andrus.
Here's a 1-1. Gets him to chase after that one.
Man, just looking lost at the plate this first AB. Some of those swings aren't even close.
Got him swinging.
Well, that's the moneymaker right there. Two strikes, slider down and away from a same side thrower as the hitter. I mean, that's just tough. You're looking to protect with two strikes and very difficult to lay off.
The 1-1. Slice the other way. That's a base hit.
He was all over that one. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Once in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
One down. And next to hit for the Sox, Mini Minoso. Ball and a strike. Anderson runs. That's in for a strike. And that's a stolen base. Not even close. One out and a runner at second. Pitch misses. Two balls, two strikes.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
The 2-2. And he chases that one. That's out number two.
You know, Boog, you often think of sliders more for that horizontal movement, but most of the good ones have both vertical depth and that horizontal movement, and that's what we saw right there. Good drop on the break and got him to swing over the top.
Stepping in, the long ball threat, Frank Thomas. Went down on strikes his first time through. The 1-1. Yeah, that's too high. Swing and a line drive, base hit out into center field. Runner from second crosses the plate, and they lead by two.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. Other than ripping one into the gap or blasting one over the wall, there aren't a whole lot of hits that are more satisfying than a nice line drive into center field, so that definitely felt good.
Runner at first with two away. Paul Konerko steps to the plate for the White Sox. He's 0 for 1.
Ball two.
Falling behind 2-1. Rip to third. Over to Biggio. That ends the frame. But they pick up one run on the RBI single. It's now a 3-1 ball game. Back after this on the show. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's the catcher, Kong Kwan Galigalao. The wind and the pitch. That one a little bit high. And now three balls and a strike. Swung on, belted. Way back there. And it hits the fence. The throw into second. Not going to get him. He's in there.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. Just about got it out of here down the line to left. So I'm sure he wishes he could have put a little more behind it, but he's got to feel good about that missile off the wall.
Jose Altuve up to hit here. Struck out swinging, leading off the bottom of the first. Runner leads away at second. On the ground to the left, and that's just foul. Singy, you think about all the success Altuve's had in the postseason, including the walk-off homer off of the Yankees and Aroldis Chapman in 2019. Only Manny Ramirez has more postseason home runs in Major League history. On to first, one gone, bottom of the third inning.
Now got it. Center fielder, Michael
Brantley stands in. Struck out swinging his first time. To the right side, Andrews tosses to first, and they get Brantley for the out.
The first baseman, number 5, Jeff
Bagwell, digs in now. He's already homered in this one. Singy, he's got a history of coming through in the big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball 4.
I don't think he really wanted to pitch to him right there anyhow.
Now back, second baseman.
Well, I think it's the ability to assess the situation, understanding what the pitcher has, what he's trying to get people out on, and then being able to use the entire field.
And the righty deals.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Corners are occupied with two down. Swing and a miss, and the count is even, 2-2.
Just a little too quick on that front shoulder, front hip, front foot. Everything comes open. No way of making contact with that one.
The pitch. Got him looking. Huge strikeout there. Two left for the Astros, and they still trail it here, 3-1. Back here in Houston, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Harold Baines. Ball to strike, the pitch. Foul ball there.
You know, these White Sox doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way, and I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of them. It's not just the three runs they've already scored. On top of that, they forced the starter to throw more pitches than he wanted to at this point of the game.
2-2 now. Fights it off, he'll see another. The 2-2. That's hard hit on the line. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One up, one down. And now it's Luis Robert. He was a strikeout victim his first time.
And that pitch count is impactful because if they can keep making him work hard out there, it may force the bullpen to get involved a little sooner rather than later.
And it's even up. Pena. Two up, two down.
He's out.
Up next for the White Sox, the third baseman, Yoan.
Two outs, bases empty. Here is Yoan Moncada. He's one for one with a two-run homer his first time up.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, it will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Two, two now. Ground ball to Bagwell. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Down in order go the White Sox, as the lead remains 3-1. Ready to go, bottom to go. Four. And stepping in for the Astros, Kyle Tucker.
Kyle Tucker.
1-2 now.
Ball inside.
Gets a piece and stays alive. And a pitch. Got him. Leadoff hitter retired in the fourth.
Well, he froze him with a great fastball right on the corner. It's kind of like bowling when you think the ball's going to get into the gutter and somehow just hangs onto that edge and knocks down a pin. Well, he got the outside corner of the plate and got that called third strike.
Here's Jordan Alvarez. Worked a walk in his first trip to the plate. Chris, it's pretty amazing to think that Jordan Alvarez could actually be a Dodger. The Dodgers originally signed him in 2016, and a little over a year later, the Astros acquired him for Josh Fields. Pretty good deal for Houston. Swings and misses. The high heat, too much on that one. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now three in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
Swing and a miss. It's a ball and two strikes.
Great deal. And you see Yordan Alvarez really emerging as that David Ortiz type of designated hitter. Even though he likes playing left field, this is a guy that has become a true force in that position, if you want to call him a DH.
Still able to come through behind in the count right there.
That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
So a man aboard, and now the shortstop, Jeremy Pena, 0-for-1 so far. In the air, foul off first. Thomas makes the play, and that's the third out. So the Astros lead one. Score holds. It's 3-1. Welcome back. Stepping in, Sebi Zavala.
The catcher, Sebi Zavala.
On the outside corner, that's strike two. And here comes. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Guys become defensive, and all of a sudden, for the hitter, that plate starts to get really wide. And what happens is, because of the pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout.
The 1-2. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock.
Well, that certainly feels good when you can win the at-bat after being down in the count, up against it with two strikes right there. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield.
Back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, the White Sox leadoff man, Tim Anderson. Hit hard, should be extra bases. Andrews around second, headed for third. Andrews coming home, the relay throw. And he's out easily.
Well, this just can't happen right there. You can't try to score from first base with less than two outs unless you can pretty much walk across the dish. And to get thrown out like that really throws water on the fire of a rally in this inning.
Minoso getting ready to hit, a guy who makes an impact not just at the plate but also in the field. And that one lifted in the air center field, and that is that. The White Sox lead one, but they still lead it 3-1. Back here at the ballpark, and here's the catcher, Kong Kwan Galigalao. The 1-1. And that one fouled off.
Well, these Astros just haven't produced as many competitive at-bats as I'd like to see in this one. Strikeouts are a little easier to stomach in baseball today, but even by those standards, they're going down way too often, and I think they're having a hard time getting any momentum going as a result.
Movement for the White Sox in their bullpen. Aaron Bummer, the left-hander, up and throwing. Graveman getting cranked up as well. The 2-2 now. And a foul ball, he stays alive. On the ground, and foul ball. Righty delivers. Swing and a miss. Got him to go up the ladder for the K.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And a pitch. Got him swinging. Oh man, for the fifth inning, moving along, two quick outs.
Just indecisive in that at bat. He couldn't commit to the slider. Tried to sit in between. Just not able to put the bat on the ball.
Line drive, and it goes just foul.
This batter has to understand his job is to get on base however he can. If he gets hit by a pitch, if he walks, maybe even singles. But you want to get the heart of the order up to the plate.
Got him looking. And the Astros put down in order. Astros go down 1-2-3, and it remains a 3-1 ball game. And welcome back. Here's a big power threat. Frank Thomas. Singing, he's a guy that covers both sides of the plate about as well as anyone in the sport. How difficult is that to do?
Well, just look at the back of my bubblegum card. You'll see how hard it is. These guys are great, man. They have the ability to look out there, but also to be able to turn on the inside pitch. Those that can really sharpen things on the outer half, those are the ones that become elite.
Next offering way upstairs. And now it's filled up. That one 95 to finish him off.
Now batting.
At the plate, Paul Konerko.
Almost 100 pitches through 5 1/3 innings. I'm thinking he's probably done in the next couple of batters.
Fouled off down the right side.
Well, he missed a hittable off-speed pitch right there. Not sure exactly with the timing. Sometimes you get a backup breaking ball. You're expecting it to make its move at the end. It never does. And you're tied up.
And he deals. Looked like it was a little bit up.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
That one is absolutely belted. Alvarez going back on it. That one is gone. A shot to left. His second of the year. And they add a run. It's 4-1. Chris, he's homered in back-to-back games now.
Yep, seeing the ball well, and he's got his timing locked in. He's looking pretty dangerous at the dish right now. Working with this kind of velocity, so critical that you move the ball around, work quickly, and make sure that you keep that hitter off balance. Clearly not fooled by the location or the velocity. He was all over that fastball.
Here comes a skipper out of the dugout, and he's ready to make the move. Roy Oswalt won't go any further, and he had a tough time keeping them in the ballgame today. We'll get a new arm when we come back. So out of the pen comes the right-hander, Luis Garcia.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep him within striking distance.
Harold Baines steps to the plate for the White Sox. Here's a 1-1. Not the best swing that time from the first-round pick. The 1-2. And a ball evens the count. Stays alive. Two on the way. Got him swinging. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
He's really good hitting the baseball the other way. So credit the pitcher for having him out in front of that pitch. Clearly he had him fooled.
And now the center fielder, Luis Robert. Next pitch is downstairs. Activity in the bullpen. Rafael Montero, the veteran right-hander, appears to be loosening up. Stanek warming up as well. The wind of the pitch. Good eye right there. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
Here is Moncada, and he's already left his mark on this game.
He certainly has, Boog. A two-run shot in the second inning, and that made an early impact on this game in a big way.
The 1-2. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. And a 1-2. And that's downed away.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity. Try to get a rollover, something on the ground. Stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
Swing and a pop-up. Pena sizes this one up. And he makes the grab. And the inning is over. But add on one more as the solo shot stretches their lead even further. It's now 4-1. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. New arm out of the bullpen, Kendall Graveman.
Still a lot of game left, and this game could go either way. So this is a big opportunity for him to get some important outs and try to help carry this lead into the later innings. Graveman.
And now the first baseman, Jeff Bagwell. He had a big swing for these guys way back in the first inning.
Yeah, Boog, he didn't waste any time in this one. The solo shot really got his team going, and he's looking for more right here.
The pitch. Up and in. Now two balls and a strike.
Looking to get something going. This is the guy you want at the plate. He's been great for this team. He is a professional hitter.
The 2-2. Swings through it for the K. Gassed it right by him.
No batter. Number seven.
Craig Biggio up next for the Astros. Throughout his career, Biggio was as durable as just about anyone. In 20 seasons, he played at least 140 games 16 times. Check swing didn't go. 2-1.
And Biggio is such a hard-nosed player. Always a dirty uniform after the game. Makes playing 1,800 straight games without a trip to the injured list even more impressive.
Close, but called a ball. Three balls and a strike.
And Biggio was a guy who could do it all. His defense, his offense, his leadership. Filled a lot of holes for the Astros.
Andrews throws the first. Two up, two down.
The right fielder, number 30, Kyle Tucker.
Two outs, base is empty. Kyle Tucker up next for the Astros. Two outs. There's a strike.
Pitching has been pretty dominant in this one, but you got to be careful. Not working with too big a lead. They could get right back in this ballgame if you're not careful.
Left-hand batter waits. And that's in the dirt. And it's 3-2. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Ronaldo Lopez getting loose out there. Crochet, a left-hander, also throwing. Right-hander kicks, deals. And there's ball four.
Boog, if I were him, I'd be nibbling around the plate as well. I mean, this guy is just capable of hitting pitches outside of the zone and driving them a long way.
Alvarez.
Now here is Yordan Alvarez. Line drive, base hit down the line. Lead runner touches second, headed for third. The relay, but he's in there easily.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there.
That was a thing of beauty. He may have been a little behind the pitch, but by getting that barrel into the hitting zone early on in his swing, he was able to meet it and still shoot a line drive down the line and left.
So two down. Now it's Alex Bregman. The next pitch misses, and it's 3-2. Right-handed reliever, and they're all loaded up.
He knew he had a little wiggle room with the open base, but now that disappears. Mistake to this next batter, and this inning might really break open.
Two outs, bases full, and now Jeremy Pena. The 1-1. Foul ball.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter, don't worry about anything else.
And now it's even up.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there. Like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
And the pitch. Just off the inside corner. And the count's full.
That's a really good take.
Two outs, bases are full. Got it by him for the K. Astros leave him loaded, and this is still a 4-1 ball game. Top of inning number 7, and now the catcher comes up to him, Sebby Zavala. Here's a 2-1. Swing and a ball hammered. Left field. That's back there. Pulls it in on the warning track. Elvis Andrus steps to the plate for the White Sox. 1-2. Here's a 1-1.
That's ball two. Two balls, one strike.
Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, that at bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there, at least to foul something off, extend that at bat.
Here's the shortstop at the plate, Tim Anderson. Pitch misses, two balls and a strike. Ground ball, left side, and that's just foul. Kicks and deals. Good job to fight that one off.
He's mixing his pitches really well. Late on that fastball after seeing the changeup. See if he can elevate one. I think if he does, he'll get the swing and miss.
Line to second, snagged on the bounce. In time, got him. And that'll do it. Three up, three down that time. Seventh inning stretch time. White Sox 4 and the Astros 1. New pitcher for the White Sox, Joe Kelly.
Well, he's the guy they hope to turn to out of the pen to lock down wins. So this game has gone to plan, more or less. Let's see if he can wrap it up here.
Here's the catcher, Kong Kwon Galigalao. Kelly. Here's a 1-1. That one blasted deep to right. Baines ranging back. Bangs off the wall. Fires to second too late. Into second with a double, and that was hard hit.
Love how he let that ball travel. Trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
Here's the former MVP, Jose Altuve. 1-2 now. Altuve waits. Anderson to first. And they get Altuve for the out.
Now back, the center fielder, Michael Brantley.
Now Michael Brantley steps in.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
And now it's 1-2. And that's in the dirt. Man, it's second. And it's filled up.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Payoff pitch. Swing and a high fly ball. Pretty well struck right field. That's bad. Gone! He circles the bases, his first homer of the year. It's 4-3. Well, that swing changes things.
Yes, it does. They were in striking distance. They found a way to fight back big time. Up in the zone is a hitter's dream. It's a BP fastball, but you're playing in real time. Most times, the pitcher's asking for a new baseball, just like right there.
Base is empty, one away. And the batter now, Jeff Bagwell. He's already homered in this game. The tying run at the plate. Next offering misses down and away.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Dives, but it kicks off his glove. He doesn't have a throw, and they don't get an out on the play.
The batter, number seven, second baseman, Greg Biggio.
So a lefty out of the pen, Aaron Bummer.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
One down, runner at first. Next to hit, Craig Biggio. Bummer deals. Downstairs, and it misses, ball four.
Now a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow Bogey found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
One out. The possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. next offering is downstairs.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
The 2-1. On the ground right side, 4-6-3. It's a double play, and that'll do it for the inning. Two-run shot for the Astros this inning. It's now a 4-3 ball game. It's Major League Baseball on the show. We're at the top of the eighth, now the number two hitter, Manny Minoso.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
That one not close, and a count 2-1. The pitch. This one smoked out to left. Alvarez makes the grab, and there's one down.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it, but in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Fouls one off, 2-2. Other thing in this park, I mean, he could sneeze one over the left field wall into those Crawford box seats. Bounce to third. Can't glove it cleanly, but plenty of time to recover, and that's the second out. The 2-1. And that one hammered. Brantley going back. Back some more. Back some more. Pulls it in on the warning track. 1-2-3 go the White Sox. But they hold on to a 4-3 lead. Ronaldo Lopez on a pitch out of the pen here.
I can't imagine any save is an easy one. You're holding a small lead on the scoreboard, and you know those hitters are going to give you the best at-bats they can, so it's always high stress. Let's see what he's got here to try and close it out.
Well, one-run game, and stepping in for the Astros, Yordan Alvarez. At the belt and fires. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Pretty big strikeout right there to start this eighth inning. Down one, any leadoff base runner really makes this inning a bit more interesting. But now this offense has to switch from possibly trying to manufacture a run to needing to run into something or just try to string multiple hits together to get a run across the plate.
Here's Alex Bregman. 2-2 now. That one just misses. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock.
Well, that was an important at bat in this game, so great job there stepping up to the challenge. There's nothing cheap about the way he got that one through the infield. That was ripped, caught out in front, and didn't get under it like he would have liked, but definitely put a good swing on.
Substitution being made at first. On a pinch run for Houston, Chaz McCormick. One down. Jeremy Pena up next for the Astros. And the right-hander deals. Ground ball up the middle. Oh, great stop. Flips it from the ground. That's one. But no throw to first as he'll hold on to it.
Well, this is obviously a tremendous play, but for me, it starts with a well-broken-in glove. To have the confidence to go down, knowing that ball is going to be right in the pocket, so you've got a clean transfer, pop back up to the feet, and fire across the diamond. Outstanding job.
Now here is Gongquan Galigalao.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field.
Ripped into right center. And now maybe extra bases. Coming home. He scores and the Astros tie it up. It's 4-4. Well, he delivers in a huge spot right there.
Oh, he's so dialed in. I don't think he even realizes how much pressure exists out there. Very easy swing, nice and relaxed. This is the type of approach you want to see guys take in this situation.
So the Houston lineup turns over. Jose Altuve up next for the Astros. Not your prototypical leadoff guy. Gets on base, yes, but also some power. Man on second, two down. That's the third. Slides. He's got it. Fires to first. And that's a nice play to end the inning. Astros pick up a run on the RBI double. All even now at four apiece. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. So coming into the game now on defense, Mauricio Dubon. He's the new third baseman. All set to start the ninth in this one. Now, Harold Baines. Ball to strike. On the ground to short, Pena. Whips it to first on the run. Now one gone in the ninth.
Well, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough. Got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and now beat it into the ground.
The center fielder, Luis Robert.
And that's ball four.
Oh, very close with the location right there. It's just tough to get rewarded on the call with pitches near the top of the strike zone.
And now Yoan Moncada. He's already homered here in this one. One away. Tie game. Go-ahead run stands at first. Checks his swing. Now an appeal to third. No swing. Just held it back there. Kicks and fires.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Tied at four. Robert on the go. Pitch in for a strike. Throw. Save. Now the catcher up to hit. Sebi Zavala.
Almost drove one out of here last time up. Flied out to the warning track.
Two down. Go ahead, run in scoring position. Hey. 2-1 pitch is in there, and the count is even. Four, four in the ninth. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Caught just shy of the wall.
Well, this guy competes hard. We see the emotion there. I love it. Great job of getting out of the jam.
White Sox going with a new arm, Garrett Crochet. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Michael Brantley to start things off.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
Swing and a miss. And that's strike two.
Big time jam right there. I hate it as a hitter, but standing in center field, you can't help but chuckle a little bit.
The next offering misses. And it's 2-2. swing and a miss. Struck him out. Some high cheese for strike three.
Just a mid-90s challenge fastball right there. Not much to it. And I'm sure he'd love another swing at it because it was in a very hittable location. Those are the swings where you can sometimes start to question yourself as a hitter and say, how did I miss that? But you know what happens.
Now it's going to be Jeff Bagwell. A laser to left base hit. And the winning run is aboard.
Having himself a really nice game at the plate. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front, kicked into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
Craig Biggio up next for the Astros. The 1-1. Bouncer to the big hurt. Over to Anderson. Double play. And we're headed to extra innings. One hit in the inning, but no one left. Tenth inning coming up. And we are tied 4-4. Back here in Houston, now it's the second baseman, Elvis Andrus.
Look for him to hit behind the runner, perhaps shoot it to the right side.
One one now. Got the back going too soon. It's strike two. The Astros have some action in their pen. Rafael Montero preparing to come on if needed. Stanek, a hard throwing right hander, up as well. Righty to the plate. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. Two now. And a swing and a miss. One away in the top half of the 10th. Tim Anderson steps to the plate for the White Sox.
Well, first base open. Really no reason to pitch to this hitter right here. Put him on. Have the force at second, first. Perhaps getting inning-ending double play.
The 1-2. That's to third. In plenty of time to first. Two in a row set down to start the 10th.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent piece of work.
Minnie Minoso steps to the plate for the White Sox. Left field. That one carrying. Pulls it in on the warning track. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and one left on. On to the bottom of inning number 10. And we are tied 4-4. Back here at Minute Maid Park. We're in extras here. And now the right fielder, Kyle Tucker. Man at second, nobody out. And Chris, certainly one of the things in his head is trying to get the runner over.
Yeah, the way that we see the game played today, though, guys are not sacrificing as much just to get that runner across. They're really looking at doing damage. Slugging is the name of the game.
One and two here. Bullpen activity starting up now. Liam Hendricks, the American League saves leader, looks to be warming up. Left-hand hitter waits. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2.
Looked like you got a little excited on that fastball. Got to think to yourself, you want to stay up the middle. That way, if you're a little bit early, you hit it out of the ballpark. You're a little late, opposite field knock.
Tied at four. Tried to check his swing. Appeal to third. Ah, and he punches him out. He went around. Here's the left fielder, Yordan Alvarez. One for three.
Listen, there's absolutely no reason to pitch to this guy right here. You nibble, you see if he'll expand his zone, but don't give him anything to hit. If you walk him, not a big deal. You have a double play opportunity set up.
Next offering way off the plate.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit's probably going to be a big run, so you really have to execute on the mound.
The count 2-1. And the throw, he's out at third. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals.
Okay.
Mauricio Dubon waiting to hit for Houston. All tied up and here in extra innings. Foul ball and it remains a full count.
Well, he gave up on that pitch early and it ended up staying in the zone. I'm sure he's kicking himself and would like that pitch again.
And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. Inning over. Now we go to the 11th, leading off Frank Thomas. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
And a pitch. And a foul ball. Here's a 1-2. Swing and a miss, struck him out. And the batter now, Paul Konerko. Outfield deep here, trying to prevent anything over their heads. And the righty deals. Check swing, appeal to first. And he won around. Just enough that time. One out. The go-ahead run is at second. Misses. Two balls, two strikes.
Man, oh man, I don't know how you take that pitch. That's as close as it gets.
Swing and a ground ball. Biggio tosses to first and two away to open the 11.
The right fielder, number 3, Harold.
So up next for Chicago, Harold Baines.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
And he grounds one back up the middle. That one sizzling on its way through to the outfield. In to score from third. And it's now 5-4.
Big swing of the bat right there to give him the lead. That was clutch. Wasn't able to elevate that one, but he sure hit it hard enough to get through the infield. There's not a whole lot of time for the defenders to react and try to make a play when it's ripped like that.
Luis Robert steps to the plate for the White Sox. Check swing, no appeal. Ball two.
Oh, this guy's going to have to slow things down. There's no reason for him to even check swing on that pitch. It was never even close.
On the ground at first. He'll do it himself. That's out number 3. So one run in the inning on this base hit. It's now a 5-4 ball game. Liam Hendricks out of the bullpen. He comes in with a chance for his second save of the season.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the White Sox, number 31, Liam Hendricks.
Here's Mauricio Dubon taking his first at bat of the game after entering on defense.
Oh, how he'd love to walk it off right here.
The 2-1.
Well, comfortable or not, these are the situations closers they seem to live for. When you get into some hot water, a jam, tough spot, whatever you want to call it, but this is where they earn their keep.
So now with one swing, this guy could end it. Check swing, now we'll look down to first. No, he held up. He swings and hits a fly ball, center field. And it falls. And now two aboard. The winning run is on base. So they hold the runner at third, wanting to play it safe. Think that comes back to bite him?
Boy, it's hard to say. That runner on second to start extras is critical, and you want to make sure you don't waste him. If they don't score this inning, there'll be some second guessing for sure.
A move coming at third base. Coming in as the pinch runner, Corey Lee. So runners at the corners, nobody out. So next up for Houston, Jeremy Pena. And now 2-1. The pitch.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Nobody out. Both the tying and winning runs on base. Roll to short, could be two. Looks to second, that's one. And a run scores on the double play.
First and third, nobody out. You're thinking you've got it lined up for a pretty big inning right here. So that double play, it's pretty deflating. They get the run in, but now they're starting all over.
At the plate is the Astros catcher, Kangkwan Galigalao. And a ball and two strikes. Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Slider got him for strike three. So it's one run, one hit, no errors, and no one left on. 11 innings in the books now. We're all tied up 5-5. Now into the ball game on defense, Corey Lee. He'll be out in left field. Rafael Montero comes on now.
Number 47. Rafael Montero.
Now the third baseman, Yoan Moncada.
Well, both sides equally as strong. So not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him on the other side of the plate.
Bounce to the left side, and it's just foul. That was close. Two and two. That misses off the outside edge. Movement in the bullpen. Ryan Stanek appears to be getting loose. Three, two. Up the middle. In plenty of time to first. One up, one down.
Now batting, the catcher, Sebi Zavala.
Sebi Zavala will hit next.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first and prevent that run from scoring.
Struck him out looking. Called strike three on a fastball up in the zone.
Well, that's a huge strikeout right there. Big second out. Infield was in. They were playing the full court press, and he got the swing and miss. Keeps this one tied. This next at bat should be a lot of fun. The odds of wiggling out of this just went up considerably.
Digging in, Elvis Andrus. Up the middle. Into the outfield. Base hit. In comes the run from third. And it's 6-5.
Well, that at bat had a lot of pressure riding on it, so really great job coming through right there. It's got to feel good. Timing on the swing was good, able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off.
Back to the top of the White Sox lineup. Tim Anderson steps to the plate for the White Sox and misses inside. Here comes a pitch. And strike two. Comes a 2-2. Battling here as he fouls it away. Check swing, he held up, and a full count now.
Really good check swing right there. So difficult to hold off on the slider from a same side thrower. Very difficult to pick up the release point.
Out to short, into the outfield, base hit. They stop the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs.
That's back-to-back singles for him. He kind of rolled over on this pitch a little bit, but he got enough behind it to shoot it through for a knock, and you'll take that anytime you can get him to find a hole.
Minnie Minoso, the next to hit. That's inside. And a count 2-1. Two outs. Couple of base runners at first and second. And he grounds one to the right side. They limit the damage here. But the RBI single pushes across a run. It's now 6-5. You're dialed into the show. Back here in Houston, bottom of the 12th inning now. And now, Jose Altuve. In a spot like this, are you up there thinking to yourself, I'm trying to end the game?
Absolutely. It's been a long one. You're hungry. And you're ready to go home.
Whoa, next offering is down low. Action in the pen down there. Jimmy Lambert, the young right-hander, up and throwing. The pitch. Swings and misses. That is strike two.
He normally does damage on that pitch in that location. Just a swing and a miss there. Don't think you want to throw it again, though.
And he deals. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Two-two now. And a good eye there. Michael Brantley up next for the Astros. And a payoff pitch. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again.
Well, he knows they don't want to give him anything to hit, but when you've got opportunities to drive in runs, you've got to expand the zone. He's capable of going out there and doing damage with it.
Thomas takes it himself. One up, one down.
Now that the center fielder, Michael Brantley.
And Michael Brantley is going to come up to hit. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure.
Line drive, that's a base hit. Runner from third in to score. That ties it up at six.
Such great concentration. Everybody on their feet, knowing that you can come through with a good swing. And there, he doesn't try to do too much.
New pitcher for the White Sox, Jimmy Lambert. He's making his second appearance of the season. One down, runner at first. Jeff Bagwell up next for the Astros. Lots of pop at the plate. Outfield playing back almost on the warning track. And it is 2-1. So a big opportunity here with the score tied and that runner on second to start the bottom of the inning.
Yeah, and you know they're eager to cash in. You just don't want to come out of your shoes and make a mistake. Got to play this smart.
Swing and a miss. 2-2 now. One down, winning run on first. Next offering is fouled back.
Just missed. If he's able to connect on that, look out.
And that one is in the dirt. 3-2 now. Craig Biggio up next. Got him! And two away now. And now, Craig Biggio. And 1-2.
One ball, two strikes.
Righty delivers. Fights it off. You'll see another.
Open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his bat down just enough to make contact with that pitch, keep the bat alive.
Two outs. That one missed. Now all even up. Gets a piece and stays alive. Two outs, but the winning run is at first. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout. Well, they pick up one run on the RBI single, and we're all even now at 6 apiece. Back now, and we're in extras. A new arm on the mound here in the top half of the inning. Ryan Stanek. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise. So digging in, Frank Thomas. He's got the power, but great contact skills. One of the best contact hitters in the game. The 1-1. And a big swing and a miss.
From a pitcher's perspective, that's a beautiful splitter right there. As a hitter, you don't like it, but he's commanded his fastball, and out of that same tunnel, that splitter comes, and the bottom just falls out of it.
And here it comes. Activity in the Houston bullpen. Brian Abreu getting ready to go. Got him! And now one away. Paul Konerko steps to the plate for the White Sox, known for his late inning heroics. Swing and a miss. And a count 1-2. All tied up here in extra innings. Next offering misses, and that's ball two. Got him swinging.
Nice work there to get the strikeout, and that's a big second out. I'll tell you, this home crowd will be fired up. They can get out of this and leave that go-ahead run stranded in scoring position. This is a big moment in this game.
Harold Baines steps to the plate for the White Sox.
RBI knock for him last time. Now a chance to drive in another run.
Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. Here comes Minnie around third. He scores back to a one-run game. It's 7-6.
Well, he found himself behind in the count right there, but he didn't give in. Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit.
Two outs. Runner on first. Luis Robert digs in now. And a pitch. Way high.
Two balls, two strikes.
Here's a 2-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The pitch. And down on strikes he goes. Good job at damage control right there. So one run in the inning on this base hit. It's now a 7-6 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Welcome back. Last half of the 13th set to go. And stepping in for the Astros, Kyle Tucker.
And things could change quickly here with one swing.
And a 1-1. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike. Activity in the pen for the White Sox. Lance Lynn up and throwing. And a 1-2. Fouls that off to the left, and we'll do it again. Next pitch misses way outside. Corey Lee waits on deck. And a pitch. And ball four to a board.
He's making things difficult for himself right now out there on the mound. But, you know, his confidence should still be high enough to get out of this. But he's going to have to buckle down right here.
Here's Corey Lee. Back to work. 3-2 now. Battling here as he fouls it away. Tying run in scoring position. And the home team trying to pull it out. Liner caught at second.
That'll drive you crazy as a hitter if you let it. I mean, he couldn't have hit that ball more on the screws than he did, and yet he's got nothing to show for it. Hang with him. I know the feeling.
Mauricio Dubon up next for the Astros. Picked up a base hit to center his first time up. And a foul ball.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boog.
Next pitch misses. 2-2.
The idea was right. Looking to locate that fastball up and in. He just missed his spot a little bit.
Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
The batter, number three.
Now it's the shortstop, Jeremy Pena, trying to deliver as the hero. Winning run is at first here in the bottom of the 13th. And that one fouled off. Two outs. Both the tying and winning runs are on. And it's even up. Got him looking. The tying and go-ahead runs are left aboard as this one is over.
A 13-inning win on the road. Very impressive all the way around. But what I like is the opportunity that certain guys who don't contribute a whole lot game to game, they came in big in this one. And I think they'll be looked upon and called upon in future games to help get the W as well.
One-run game here today. Your final score, 7-6. A one-run extra inning win for Chris Singleton and our entire crew. I'm John Ciampi saying so long.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious White Sox, seven runs on 10 hits. No errors, they left nine runners on base. For the Astros, six runs on 12 hits. No errors, they left 14 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 44 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely. Mm-hmm.